So one of my friends on Facebook was talking about people wearing pajamas in public. And I had a student once who used to wear her pajamas into a 3 o'clock class, but she did a lot of other strange things too. Finally, I had to tell her not to do her math homework during English class. But I had beyond her, I had not witnessed many people wearing full sets of pajamas in public. I have noticed some guys wearing pajama bottoms out in public. But at any rate, my friend had said something about people wearing pajamas. And I said, oh yeah, like it's a problem. And he said, Google it. And I did. And of course, it immediately took me to pictures of people at Walmart. I worked at Walmart for 2 years before I went back to school and got my master's degree. And I don't know. I never saw people wearing quite those outfits when I worked there, but the pictures certainly tell a story about what people think is acceptable to wear in public. Now, myself, I will put on a pair of heels and pantyhose to go to Walmart because I think a person should look his or her best whenever, because you never know who you're going to meet, whom you are going to meet. Man, I got to get those pronouns correct. So I told you all I've known about hair. Maybe, I don't know, maybe not. But I washed my hair yesterday, and I did pretty much of a blow dry job on it yesterday because I was going out to meet someone for coffee, and I didn't want to go out with my head sopping wet. And so I don't usually do that, though. Usually I just do my bangs. And ouch, ouch, ouch. There I was, you know, before saying, I don't get any tangles. Well, every once in a while I do, but they pull out really easily. But at any rate, I braided it. And so here is Gwen's hair again the day after she washed it. Now, after I started using the Dove shampoo, I liked the way it made my hair feel from the point of view of feeling it like this, but it tended to make my hair a little bit limp, and I don't like limp hair. Now, however, I have this shampoo and this conditioner because I bought it and I have to use it. So yesterday when I washed my hair, I used the Dove shampoo to wash it, but I used a fruit tea for length and strength. I don't think it's called that anymore, as a conditioner. And I use lots of conditioner on my hair because conditioner keeps it from tangling and gives it a healthier feel and a healthier look. Now, I know this is going to be shocking and surprising to some people, but I have come under attack for saying that people should trim the frickin' ends of their hair. But I'm going to reiterate it. Get your ends trimmed. Do it yourself. And you know, if you cut off like a quarter of an inch every month or every couple of months or even every 3 months, you're not going to be sacrificing your hair length. But you are going to have healthier hair, and it will even make it appear that your hair is growing faster, because it won't, which it won't be. It's like an optical illusion, because you will have less breakage and more of your hair will stay, I want to say in place, but that's not the words that I want. Yeah, why not have healthy, good looking hair? So what else do I have to say? I had a hard time deciding which shoes I was going to wear to school today, but I'm going to leave that. I'm not going to discuss that right now, though I might discuss it at a later date. And so you're saying, Gwen, why are you rambling and babbling on about pajamas? Because I have my pajama bottoms on, which happen to be men's pajamas, but I don't sleep in them. Look at that. I cannot talk. I don't sleep in them because I just don't see the sense of sleeping in clothes. I mean, that's what bed covers are for. That's what blankets and quilts are for. So I do put on my pajamas when I get up in the morning because I have neighbors. And I open my curtains because I also like a lot of light, and I'm sure that my neighbors don't want me to, you know, not have my pajamas on, even though I only have two across the road who would actually look in. And one of them is my 70-something-year-old neighbor named Mary. And Mary's quite an interesting character, and I know that she watches my house because she asked me questions like, is your computer in your kitchen? I'm like, no, Mary, why would you even think that? And she said, because sometimes in the middle of the night, the light comes on in my kitchen. And she thought it was me in there working on my computer. And I said, Mary, that's me getting up in the middle of the night to get a drink of water. I don't know how she put that together and this together and got computer. But no, she also told me that she always watches my garage because I don't have one of those automatic. I have the automatic door, but I don't have the controller. So when I leave my garage door open. And she says she spends all day long watching my garage. So no horrible person or animal runs in there and steals my vintage dishes or whatever. I don't know. But anyway, so Mary watches me. And I don't really have a problem with that. And my neighbor across the road, I don't think that he watches me very closely because I think he actually has somewhat of a life. But I do put on my PJs and walk around the house. I wouldn't even walk out to the mailbox in my pajamas. No. I just don't have a lot to say. Actually, I have a lot of not to say because I'm not really saying anything of substance. You notice me doing that with my hair. I'm just emulating people whom I have seen who do the hair thing because I have hair. I don't know that you noticed that, and I'm not afraid to show my face, and I don't expose my rather large derriere and cut off shorts while I'm showing my hair. But hey, that's just a little bit of catty gossip on my part. Don't pay any attention to it. I'm going to stop now. I rambled for 7 minutes, 36 seconds, 37, 38, 39, 40. So I'm going to stop. You know, take care of your hair and don't wear your pajamas.